Tonight from the Rosemary Permeter Student Activity Center at North Hills, our ICTN Game of the Week. It's a battle of the predatory animals tonight as the Ranchview Wolves take on the Panthers of North Hills. And good evening, everyone. John Nelson alongside Rob Willman. Both teams kind of in a streak of winless contests. Both teams at 0-5, and both teams coming off of losses. As you see, the Ranchview Wolves, they're coached by D. Boyd. As we take a look at the 10-4A standings, Lincoln and Carter atop, undefeated. Pinkston a game back, and then it's Wilmer Hutchins. North Hills coached by Kenneth Gober, and there's head coach D. Boyd of the Wolves, coming off a loss to Roosevelt. Richardson, Cunanan, Atkins, Ulette, and Wainwright. Just one senior starting for the Ranchview Wolves. And for the Panthers, Unial, Nogoka, Aquilo, Shaboot, and Millhorn. And we are underway, and here's Rob Willman, a fast start.
Well, unfortunately, the first shot of the ball game, Shaboot hit a three-pointer, but he's called for traveling. So for the prep school, it's a school that you get in via the lotto because so many students from across the Metroplex, it is an open campus, apply to this school, but you got to be a genius. You got to be like John Nelson to get in.
Top 25.
There's a drive, no whistle, ball is loose. Ulette is there. We've got a jump ball position. Arrow goes to the Wolves.
These are young teams. North Hills just one senior, four juniors, six sophomores. Ranchview, the enrollment a little bigger, five seniors, and expected to play pretty well tonight.
Richardson over to Atkins. Atkins back around the hall. Right there, top of the key. Ball goes in and out on a shot by Ulette, and it's rebounded by Prep here in the corner. The three-pointer missed by Millhorn. Not a lot of guys will play for North Hills. They have a limited bench, three-pointer side, pocket not there for Wainwright. Some fresh faces for D. Boyd getting the starting nod tonight. It's a young team, and he says the seniors that he has, they didn't play varsity last year. Just underway. Glad you could be with us. It's a dreary night outside. A little chilly and started to rain here late afternoon. Atkins decides to back out as Shaboot had him cut off on the drive train, and Shaboot is there, long arms, nice reach, nice defensive play.
You can see the intimacy here. We are literally on the court. There's the head coach, Kenneth Gober, was at Texas Wesleyan as a player, is in his fourth year, the school overall in his 20th year, just off Royal Lane.
Cameron Yard just checked in as Richardson, who does a lot of the ball handling, is at the top of the key, fakes the drive, kicks it out. Someone make a three, and they do, and that's going to be Cunanan, the first three-pointer for the sophomore, and the first three-pointers tonight. He's averaging close to 5 points a ball game. A couple of the leading scorers not playing tonight for D. Boyd and company, so he's got to go to the bench. In fact, we look at some cross outs. He's got about five players not out there tonight that he had earlier this season. Back around the horn we work it. Millhorn might have pushed off the drive off the window. Count it. The junior gets it to fall. Nice little drive. And he'll go to the line to look for the three-point play.
And another look at it. Here's a drive, and no question about the call. Not permanently set in the lane. Nice call as a Millhorn followed through the shot and as successful on the free throw attempt.
So a three-pointer for Luke, the junior, and we're tied at three apiece. Early stages, first quarter. Ranchview in the dark uniforms. North Hills in the light. Trimmed in green. There's Yard, back up to Richardson. Richardson gives it back over here to Atkins. Atkins around the horn, and they get it back over to Ulette. A shot, hired miss. Yard goes high for the rebound, and plucking it away from everyone was Cunanan. A lot of these players, again, for the Wolves, have seen limited action up until the last couple of weeks, so they've been forced into play. So they're growing a little bit. Richardson, the southpaw, misses. Rebound to Aquilo. Aquilo will take it over the timeline. going left against Richardson, drives and scores. So he gets the runner, and the home team is up by a deuce under 5 minutes to go. So a little up and down right now in the early stages. And the North Hills fans hollering out some defense. Yard. In the corner, Atkins. Atkins forced that one a little too hard. Yard with the rebound. It's blocked by Nowaka. And defensively right now, North Hills doing the job. Nowaka. The drive and count it.
Aquilo. Second leading scorer on the team, John Henry Nowaka, is the team's leading scorer.
So Aquilo hits a couple of back-to-back drives, and the home team up by four, the halfway point of the first quarter. Glad you could join us on ICTN. Yard, who was here at one time, that's going to be a travel. Cameron, a 6'2 senior. Maybe seeing some familiar faces as he comes back over. There is D. Boyd.
D. Boyd, year number 13, a team that went to the state about 7 years ago.
Aquilo up top, and they get the long-range bomb by Milhorn. He's now got 6 points, and just like that, it's a 10-3 North Hill Panther lead. Atkins out to Richardson. Richardson on the point. Nowaka, who's a little bit taller than Richardson, has been called upon to guard Richardson. In the corner, Richardson, the southpaw, can't get it to fall. Rebound, Atkins kicks it around the yard, and it's knocked out of bounds by Milhorn with the quick hands. And Ranchview will keep control. The thing about Ranchview is they're pretty much shooters, and so goes the shooting, so goes the team.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a case right now of North Hills taking Ranchview out of their game. Ranchview just a little cold here in the first 5 minutes.
Yeah, very few drives that you'll see by the Wolves, and you let missed it. Richardson, another three-pointer attempt, hits the back iron. Last touch by Ranchview, and the Panthers will have control, and a 30-second timeout called by Coach Gober for North Hills as his team has a 7-point lead here in the first quarter.
That ball last touched by Cameron Yard, number 25. Ranchview comes in, Rob. They're led in scoring by Evan Atkins. He's averaging 8 a game. He's the 6-foot junior. And as you mentioned, a couple of the top scorers are out. Brandon Kirk. Also, Barry, a junior.
I was teasing the coach before the game for Ranchview. I said, your two wins have come against pretty good perennial powers. Kennedale, one of those. You were in Kennedale's district at one time. You beat them by a point. You beat the Colony 56-52, and then everything else kind of craters around you.
Yeah, they come in averaging just 39 points in district. They give up right at 60.
It's just the OJ not falling through the net.
Right.
Fadeaway shot in and out by Aquilo. Rebound Richardson. You know that one team's not going to be hot the entire game. Someone's going to cool off. There's going to be the ebb and flow. Atkins loses on the baseline. A couple of Panthers are there, and Nowaka eventually comes up with it. And he's there on the far side going to the wing, and it's picked. Ouellette with the pick. Cunanan on the wing over to Richardson. Ouellette. Nowaka might have got a piece of ball, but also a piece of the player. And that'll be the first foul for the home team, and going to the line is Denzel Ouellette.
North Hills with two team fouls. And Denzel, a 6'1 junior, averaging just 3 a game, and a chance to cut that lead in half.
67% free throw shooter makes that one.
Caleb Arnold, a freshman, the only freshman on the floor now for the Wolves.
Also coming in, Trevetti, a sophomore for North Hills, will come in. And setting down will be Nowaka. As the junior, Ouellette hits the second free throw, so he's 2 out of 2. three free throws in all in this ball game by both teams combined. In the first quarter, everybody's made one. Not a lot of fouls being called, just the way we like it, folks. Up and down the court, no D.
Yeah.
Bombs away, missed by Chabot. Richardson, numbers are not in his favor, so he pulls back. Kanami over in the corner to the freshman. Arnold stops. Yard back around to Richardson. Ouellette, he's still on the point. Long bomb, count it. By Caleb Arnold, the freshman, coming off the bench to hit the three-pointer. It's two threes so far and a couple of free throws for the Wolves to give them the 8 points as we're getting close to the end of the first quarter of play. New player there is Cram, number 13, almost loses. Aquilo to his left, tries a head fake. Boy, a good screen that time by Trevetti. Ball is rejected away by Trevetti, but he's going to be called for the foul. Let's see if it's him or perhaps Cram, number 13, Garrett, who you're looking at right there, the sophomore. And now we have some more substitutions as Nawaka goes back in. And Yunyal, number one, who started this ball game, comes back in.
Only freshman on the team.
Trevetti will have a seat. And now you find the Wolves down by just a bucket. A minute to go. The sophomore Arnold. Kunanen. Kunanen against Aquilo. Richardson with the head fake. Gets him to move out. Ulett, the three-pointer, count it. And it's just raining threes. Nothing unusual about this Ranchview team. They'll put up their fair share. This is how many will fall. Once everything's said and done, top of the key, hits the iron and missed. The good effort by Nawaka, but rebounded by Ranchview. Less than a minute to go, half a minute to go in the first quarter. I would say Ranchview would want to try to hold it for the last shot, but that's just not in their DNA.
Well, they made up 7 points, having trailed 10-3.
Now they spread them out a little bit, and Coach Boyd's telling his post players to get out of the way and make some room. Kunanen's going to go to the hoop. Draws the foul and gets the shot to fall. Cole Kunanen, who averages almost 5 points a ball game, 5'8 sophomore, and gets it to work for him.
Had a couple of shots earlier that kind of circled the rim. This one circled and went down.
Kilo being called for the foul. You saw the hack. And now a chance for the three-point play and count it. No one's missed a free throw here in the first quarter. Nawaka.
That may be a three-shot foul.
Hold your horses.
Yeah, he was pushed, and he'll go to the line with three shots.
Well, he will go to the line. Again, no one's missed a free throw in the first quarter. The old sportscaster's jinx always works.
It did.
He missed the first one. So a chance for the home team to close the gap dramatically. And right now, John Henry can't do it. He's got one more shot. Here's the foul again.
Right on the top of the line in the push.
He makes one out of three. And that's how the quarter will end. Ranchview on top 14-11 against North Hills. Back with the second quarter in a moment. Four three-pointers combined here in the first quarter. Not one team missed a free throw until the clock had expired in the first quarter, and Nawaka had missed his first two. And that's where we stand now, the Wolves on top by three, and we've got a backcourt violation right off the bat against North Hills.
Ranchview coming off a 61-36 loss to Roosevelt, but all time it's been all Ranchview in their series against North Hills. This is the fifth meeting.
Ouellette on the right wing. Bounce pass. Oh, they had it set up, but very nicely done as Nawaka He pivots that foot just in time and evades the traveling call. Morocco, top of the key, going for three. Missed. Hewlett kept it alive, and Yard eventually gives over to Richardson. North Hills lost to Roosevelt as well by 10 points. A couple of those top teams in district, they only dropped by 10. And you pick your victories where you can, and that's where they picked one of them, a blocking foul. First, I thought they were going to call a charge against Hewlett, and trying to draw that was Cram, number 13, but then at the last minute, the official said, no, we're going to go blocking.
And team foul number, that's one of those either or. On second look, pretty tight call. Fourth team foul assessed to the Panthers.
Minute gone by in quarter number two. No one's yet to score. Dunanen backs up a little bit, and now he gets the offense in motion. Richardson, who was in the wing. Hewlett, nice indeed. He now has 7 points. Just worked the line and drove the paint. Aquila, nice get and go. Not there. Ball is tipped around and eventually comes down to Ranchview. Kananen, fast break. Richardson, left open, traveling. They said he shuffled his feet.
Jordan Richardson in the corner, the senior. Got that pass from about 35 feet. That's a long pass hurled by Kananen. I don't think they did get to it.
Yeah, tried to catch him napping a little bit. There's a drive. No one was there to block it, and Shaboot gets the first 2 points of the game, but Nowaka, I think he could have just walked on in and scored 2 points himself, but he gets the assist, and nonetheless, the Panthers get on the board. Break a little dry run there. Still down by three. And a travel called against Arnold.
Followed through with a shot, but does not count. Took 3 steps. And a chance with a three for the Panthers to tie it up.
Aquila in the corner. Long range shot missed by Milhorn. Saved. Nicely done. Nowaka to the left. He goes for three. Misses everything. Arnold will push it up. Goes in the middle. Kunanen missed it. Fast break, Aquila. And a foul can be charged against Ranchview.
It's going to be on Kunanen, and team foul number four. Rob's having to play scorekeeper and traffic cop, letting Ranchview know that you have to go to the table to our right. A lot of people think that maybe this is the official table. It
well,
is not.
We look official. We have a monitor. Nowaka misses. One and done. Atkins. Bounce pass. Boy, that is played all the way around. Cameron Yard at the point. He's looking for someone and finds Arnold. Bounce pass over Atkins. He had a lot of room, thought about it. Didn't like the mismatch, Arnold. Arnold, nice little bounce pass inside. Playing catch with Atkins. North Hills doing a really good job defensively of not giving the Wolves much to look at, and Richardson just fires away. His first three-pointer, he averages about 36% from behind the arc. And that was back at their high school.
Leads the team in threes, his 25th of the year.
Aquila tried to go inside to Milhorn. Little miscommunication there.
And they couldn't get around Yard, number 25, who had him sealed off on the baseline. How many times have you wanted to call number 25 Camden?
Corner shot good, three-pointer, Richardson. And a push. It's going to be against Arnold. Coach Boyd wanted an offensive foul, didn't get it. Team foul 5 now against Ranchview.
Almost halfway through, quarter number 2.
Yeah, really good pace. Both teams up and down. Think about this North Hill program. Academics comes first, and there's many times that Coach Gober said player had to miss practice for an exam, take a test. That basket is good by Chabot.
Well, yeah, I mean, the senior class is only 165. Total enrollment K through 12 is almost 1,500, so just 165 this senior class.
And the thing is, they have 1,000 applicants waiting on the waiting list to get in. It's a free school, but you've got to have the grades. Arnold, he got another. May I have another?
Thank you. From Valley View and 161.
So the lead is now 10. And North Hills, they need to find their shot. They started really great there in the first 4 minutes of the first quarter. There's a travel going to be called against Arnold. And checking in will be Thompson for Ranchview.
It's Roderick Thompson, 6 foot junior, wide body. What, about 230 maybe?
Is Kunanen back in? He is in. Yeah, he's, and he's playing up on the point and playing on the big guy, Nuwaka. So D. Boyd, who usually has about 15 players on his roster, missing about five of those. And it didn't take our man Thompson long to commit a foul, did it, John?
Just came in at about 12 seconds, assessed his first, the team's fourth. I mean, there's virtually no room from the baseline to the padded wall. I stepped it off at 4.5 feet.
Oh, nice little pass. Wide open underneath is Cram. Two-point shot. Aquila and company doing a good job underneath. And Coach Boyd says, you know, that was too easy. I'd like a timeout, please. So with just under 3 minutes to go before the half and the Wolves up by eight, this is what we call a coaching moment. But again, for this North Hill team, Coach Gober is saying, you know, we can't practice until the first day of basketball season. It's not like you have an off season. And he goes, a lot of these charter schools, they get the rap that they, you know, recruit teams. I said, no, that's those schools in Louisiana for football teams.
No, this is uplift.
Yeah, this is uplift. I understand, Coach. And uplift is spread all across the country, and they've just opened one up in Grand Prairie that started out as a elementary middle school. So you'll see more of those popping up, but it's just how they establish what district and where to put them in the UIL. That's interesting for me as Richardson steps out of bounds. He said a lot of times it's just where you're at attendance-wise, where your campus is at is where the UIL will place you. He goes, he's just happy they didn't put him in Nimitz's in MacArthur's district.
Well, it's the fourth year they've been part of the UIL, and they have made the playoffs, had the Panthers the last 2 years.
Yeah. Those districts a little more conducive, I believe,
right,
for their liking. John Henry called for the travel. I don't think there's enough two first names players. You know, John Henry, the only time you hear that is if someone did something bad and they're in the news and they give them their whole name. Richardson!
Oh,
three 3-pointers. I know the last two have been, you know, way outside.
Well, you can also have a third name if you go to the rodeo. A lot of the bull riders.
They go threes. Closing in on 2 minutes here in the first half. And the goal now for the Panthers, they don't want to get this slip away from them. Aquila, baseline, in and out. New player is Kevin Collins, 55. He's in there now. Kunanen back over to Atkins. Inside to the Biggin, and that could have been a travel or a jump. They're going to call a jump ball. Possession arrow goes to the direction of Ranchview.
Yeah, Cram reached in, number 13, had it long enough to warrant the thumbs up.
And now Trevetti steps in, and sitting down will be Chabot, who started for North Hills.
You see how tight it is
both quarters underneath.
Won't stop Richardson at all. Well, just trudging his way to the basket was Collins. A little awkwardness there, but no foul, no turnover. Rushing to the hoop, but Collins is there for the rebound. He can fill the lane, that's for sure. A wide body. Kananen for three, in and out. Ball tips around. Richardson gets it. Kananen goes, I'll give it to Richardson. He's made three threes, looking for four. Collins couldn't keep it in play. Kicks it over. Now in control is Nwaka, under a minute to go. Long shot is failing the Panthers here in the second quarter. And now perhaps Coach Boyd says, let's just take the last shot. He's telling everyone to spread out, and Atkins gives it back to Kananen. If they don't go inside to the big guy, look for number four or five. That's Richardson. He's the one that's been shooting the long shots.
Yeah, they're expected to play well, and they certainly have here in the second quarter.
Atkins, Kananen, and they're calling out a set play. Kananen goes all the way to the hoop. Off the window, that was too easy. So the half has reached us with a 30-17 lead by the Wolves. The outside shooting of Ranchview, the difference here. And what has been an up and down, really fun game here after two quarters. We'll have some stats, highlights, and we'll have the second half here in a moment. Stay with us.
Welcome back to North Hills, more specifically the Rosemary Permuter Student Activity Center. A 13-point halftime lead by the Wolves of Ranchview. Let's take a look at some of the first quarter highlights. And North Hills got out to a 7-3 lead. They go inside and outside. They drive with John Aquillo, two of his 4 points. And then the nice dish off to Nwaka, who's coming off a 21-point game in Ranchview with 16 points. In that second quarter, a couple of those threes. There was a second of four threes. Ulette finished with 7 points. And then Caleb Arnold, the freshman, connecting on one of his twos. And then at the top of the key, Jordan Richardson, who landed three threes, connects. He's got 27 threes on the year. Ranchview outscoring North Hills 16-6 in that second quarter. Jordan Richardson and Kananen, the two leading scorers for the Wolves of Ranchview. Milhorn, Aquillo, and Chabot, the top three scorers for the Panthers of North Hills. They inbound from across the way to begin the second half, and here's Rob.
Well, we had a really good, fast-paced first half. Not a lot, maybe, what, one, two timeouts, one from each team. Not a lot of trips to the free throw line. And when the teams make shots, boy, that whole thing goes by really fast. Here's an outlet to Richardson. Kananen with a nice feed, and Richardson now in double figures.
Came in averaging 7.
And talking to Coach Boyd and saying, you know, you don't have anybody in double figures this year. And so that's just pretty much highlights the type of year we've had. Loose ball and a timeout called by Gober for North Hills.
And he did get it in time.
See that a lot. Seems like week in and week out. Coach Boyd saying, you know what, Rob, it finally ran out on me. We talked about the fact he's made the playoffs every year. And I said, yeah, sooner or later it's going to catch up to you. And he says it has. This is the year it catches up with him. He said maybe a few more gray hairs to go with it. But, hey, you can't be perfect. You knew sooner or later they would have a season where they just wouldn't make postseason. And the thing is, most of that was just youth, and he's got a lot of guys coming back. As you take a look at Coach Boyd there, Richardson out there now is a senior. and the one really just making all the plays. That's about it. Aquila kicks out and around the horn into Waka. Waka pushed by Cunanan, and so he will go out of bounds to inbound. The first foul. Almost played a minute here in the third quarter of play. North Hills in the white, trimmed in green. The putback, pretty good effort there by Shaboud, but it wouldn't fall, and a traveling call underneath on the rebound by Yard.
Yeah, Shaboud went over the top of Yard to get the rebound, then Yard apparently shuffled the feet, got called the travel.
Inbound, Milwaukee missed a wide open shot. Boy, that was a great play to set it up offensively, just couldn't finish it. Richardson thinks otherwise as Shaboud with that long arms and wingspan. Got in his face, but then they left him free again, and he just nails his fourth three-pointer of the ball game. 5 points, all 5 points here in the third quarter of play. Aquila, he gets the three. And finally, it seems that maybe the Panthers get off the schneid a little bit as they're down by 15. It could be a long third and fourth quarter if their shooting doesn't come back here in the second half. Richardson again, air ball. Looks at the coach. He's like, come on, coach, I've made, what, four of these?
Yeah, that came right in front of him.
Yeah.
That's his worst looking shot.
Yeah, if you're gonna really make a bad one, don't do it in front of the coach. A foul called. It's gonna be called against Yard as they called him for the hack. Nuwaka could have been called maybe for the travel. Kind of made a step to his right and planted his leg and kind of shimmied, did the two-step turn.
You saw a lot of that over the weekend.
Yeah, Boyd arguing his case. It's Nuwaka who missed three. Yeah, watch right there. Oh, he took it right in the kisser.
Man, a high elbow and a shoulder as well.
Makes them both, so now Nuwaka has made his last three, so improves his mark a little bit. Yeah, John was referring to the fact the Fort Worth Stock Show and Rodeo started a week ago. This game's being taped on January 17th, 2017. First time went to the parade in downtown Fort Worth. A lot of cowboys, cowgirls, horses and donkeys.
You buy anything?
Not a thing. Cunanan misses, ball tipped around, rebound, Cram. Cram needs some help in the backcourt, and Aquila's there. Aquila over the timeline. Cunanan might have hurt his leg.
Yeah, he's down.
From behind the play. He's still in pain as they take a shot from the top of the key, and now timeout is called, and he was holding his leg. He got tangled up.
Couldn't tell if he was tripped or kicked.
Oh, I think he stepped on Ulette's foot, maybe, a teammate. He either stepped on his teammate's ankle to avoid him, or he just landed crooked, again, trying to avoid a teammate as they got tangled up a little bit there on the near side.
We're in between both benches. I mean, we're only about 3 feet away from either bench. We can hear what is said, what is called, what play is drawn up. Oh, yeah. And a nice hand as Cole Cunanan, sophomore, comes out.
Looks, I believe he hits Ulette right there. See, and it's not even, not did he step on top of it. It's like his toe just kind of, it's like you stumped your toe. When you stump your toe into something, that's what he did. He stumped his toe on a teammate.
Yeah, Ulette was on the chase to guard Aquila.
So a 13-point Wolf lead after that timeout, and a steal by Nuwaka. Going the distance and scores. He's made the last four, and a nice play defensively for the Panther.
And coming off a 21-point game and a loss last week.
Down by just 11, fans wanting the defense on the campus of North Hills. First time I can recall ICTN being here. Bounce pass over, so it's our inaugural visit to the prep school. Atkins pulls back, and I think Coach Boyd says, I want a full timeout, and he will get that at the 4:44 mark of the third quarter.
Our first visit, this facility built 3 years ago, the Rosemary Perimeter Student Activity Center. To say it is small and intimate and tight is an understatement. I mean, we are literally on the court. We're not a foot away from the sideline marker. Between both benches, there's a stage to our right, baseline to the wall about 4.5 feet, and just one area for bleacher seating, which only goes 5 rows. There's a stage. What's playing tonight?
Well, we talked about the Fort Worth Stock Show and Rodeo and all the horses that I was able to look at the parade a week ago. Well, this is right in the area of the Equestrian Center in Irving. Used to play polo just east of this campus, about a block.
Curtain is drawn.
What is behind the curtain? We have no idea. Back into action. We usually like to see something good happen after a timeout. Ranchview did not comply. Milwaukee in the corner. Aquila wants three-pointer. Back iron shot. A couple of people fight for it. Yard. Ball's loose. And it's a travel. Cram came down with it. But he slid, and that was the travel.
Couldn't stop the slide, but there's nothing he could do. He got the ball, and just his body momentum.
Right about the halfway point of the third quarter. The pace slowing down just a little bit. Nice defensive play by the Wolves, and a jump ball. A travel. A travel by Arnold. And now checking in will be Myers. Myers, number 4, 6'2", averages a couple of points a game. He played here at one time. And the first time we've seen him tonight, he's going to come out on the point. Milwaukee, left corner. The starter, Milhorn, gives it back to Milwaukee, and in the corner, Aquila. Faces everywhere. Milhorn and a foul called on the court. This is going to go against the Wolves.
Maybe their third team foul.
Richardson with the call. Again, not a lot of fouls called coming up next week. Vikings and Tigers.
Well, they got the Panthers and the Wolves. The Panthers probably a little more dangerous than the open field.
Myers will pick up his first personal foul. And just like that, the team fouls are piling up a little bit against Ranchview here in the third quarter. None called against the home team. And maybe that's what the Panthers are trying for. Another foul called. This is called against Myers. He very quickly picks up two. That right after that play, the previous foul, if you noticed, North Hills just spread everybody out and tried to open up the lanes. Milhorn from the corner, he gets it.
His second three.
That was a nice shot in the arm for the Panthers. They've cut it to 8. Inside, get it back out. Atkins fakes the drive, did not find an open lane. They go inside, and that's good by Yard, his first 2 points of the ball game.
They tried to do that earlier with Richardson trying to get her down low to Yard.
Kick out to Milhorn. Milhorn going to try it again. We've seen a few of those shots where they just hit the back of the iron. Bounce pass, Myers, no look, Yard. Yard of three guys in his face. Hewlett might have had some room. The no-look pass. Yard, no look. Atkins from three in and out. Hewlett played it nicely. Did a good job. Blocked off the defender. Got the putback and the offensive rebound to make it count. And the lead is back in double digits. It's up to 12. 2 minutes to go. Aquila. Second time. In as many shots, we've seen a Panther hit just the back part of that iron. and kick out, not getting any rotation on the ball. And a little flat shot. And both times limited to just one and done. Hewlett had no intentions to try to shoot then. He was just looking to kick it out and reload. Myers, right side, takes about three steps. Count it. 41-27. And the lead just stretches and stretches like my waistband. There's an offensive foul. Charge against Nowaka. And Ranchview is within a few minutes of really just blowing this one out.
They led by as many as 18 tonight.
Defensively blocked away by the Panthers. Aquila tried to go behind his back and Richardson picked his pocket. Atkins is open, but Richardson's going to take the three. Richardson, his fifth three-pointer of the ball game. And as Coach Boyd told me, if we make the threes, we're pretty darn good. Those things just have not been falling for the Wolves this year.
Team three-pointer number nine.
Coach Gober's going, why does it have to happen now? Bounce around about three times for Milhorn. Maybe a little frustration on the Panthers side as they commit the foul, their second team.
And the first on Chabot.
So a 17-point lead could be the last possession of the third quarter. Richardson, Ouellette, Myers, bounce pass off the foot of one of the Wolves. Could have been a kick. They call the jump ball possession arrow goes for North Hills. It's a manual. It's an analog.
I don't have a remote.
No, they have a human remote that flips the possession arrow around. 22 seconds to go. Still 17 Aquila. Boy, that was a tough shot. That would have really been a nice play if that one had fallen, but he really didn't do himself any favors with that angle he was taking on the baseline. 7 seconds, Myers out to Richardson. Go ahead, just take it from there. Go ahead, shoot it from there. Oh, nice bounce pass. Hewlett from the corner. Doesn't count, but still another outstanding quarter as the Wolves outscore the Panthers 14-10. As we finish three, headed for four, our score, Ranchview 44, North Hills 27, back with the final quarter in a moment. Well, we've got a quarter to go, and right now it's all Ranchview, 44-27. Atkins took a lot of steps and drew the foul. Might have been Trevetti, number five. That'll be the third team foul. And going to the line will be Atkins, looking for his first points of the game. I mean, the guy's been averaging about 8.5. But tonight, it's all been his teammate Richardson, who's been throwing in threes like crazy. We've got a bunch of fresh faces coming out there for North Hills. Some players who have not played tonight. Rahimi, one of those. Atkins makes the second, so he's 2 out of 2. Cram stays out there.
Troy
Pula stays out there.
Out there.
Gunyar is back out number one. He started but didn't really stay out there much after that. And right over here to the near side to Rahimi. Rahimi is going to be fouled as he tries to make a move to the basket.
And that's the sixth team foul assist to Ranchview.
Thing about North Hills, unlike some of the private schools in the Metroplex, this is a co-ed school. Well, runner comes up a little short by Phillip. And it's the first shot here of the fourth quarter. Long shot made again. It's Mr. Richardson. He now has 18 points, 6 3-pointers. What a night. Aquila air ball and the outlet to Myers. Myers with a 3-on-1. Go ahead, Richardson, take it. Let's see how many more of these you can make. You let the Adkins. Near side, Myers, a travel called. You know, you look at those players, and as soon as a whistle's called, you know, they all turn to their coach. They all look at his reaction.
What did I do wrong, mm-hmm. or did I really do that in your eyes?
Right, right. Well, Coach Gober says, all right, guys, y'all, you get your minute because the starters have got to go back out for the Panthers. So that was short-lived. Shaboot still in there along with Milwaukee. There's Shaboot, little air ball, headed for the stage and might do the disappearing act.
Almost through the curtain, opening act.
Now this is the final act for sure. 22-point lead for the Wolves. I don't see North Hills coming back to send this any longer. And count that one as Chance Myers. It's another one. He'll go to the line looking for a 3-point play. Again, Myers came in averaging about a point and a half a ball game. Nice little overhand move there.
And we're going to see Scott Williams, number 22, in the game for the first time.
Williams, a 6'1 senior. Bounce pass and a foul against Mr. Williams.
And Sir Roderick Thompson, the junior, poised to come back in as well, and here he is.
He will come in, and Yard, is it Yard that goes out?
Uh-huh.
Yes, Yard will go out. So now we have Thompson and Collins. They did that in the latter stages of the second quarter. Milhorn makes the free throw. He's now in double figures with 10 and missed the second. It's interesting to see how the UIL, when they first started allowing the private schools to our charter schools to come into district play, and how they handled what classifications they would be in.
To me, that's the harder job than enrollment.
Yeah. But if they just use the boundary method, you know, where is the school located, what district is it in, and who cares about your size?
Yeah, your farthest bus trip's 5 minutes.
Yeah, and you walk up. Nice little defensive play, poked that one away, and a foul's called as Shaboot took a pretty good hit by Thompson.
Sideswipe Thompson, the slower to get up.
Sir Roderick looked like a linebacker out there.
The eighth team foul.
Right, boom, right there. And now Kaleem, who has 4 points, this will be his first chance of a free throw. Rattles that in.
One team assured of snapping a losing streak tonight in District 10-4A.
Both coming in 0-5 in district play. Second shot good by Shaboot. He will sit down and Travati will come in, the sophomore. But it's been around double-digit lead or more about the midway point of the third quarter and on as the hot shooting of these Wolves. And now the big guy, Collins, makes it count inside, and he has the opportunity for a 3-point play.
Oh, they like that. Just get straight elevation over Cram. Little mismatch in height there.
He banked in the
with authority.
Free throw. Yeah. Banked in the 3-point play and a 25-point lead. Milhorn over to the point, and they give it to Aquila. Aquila, now there's another tough shot. Aquila, he had been quiet up to that point. Boy, he scored two right off the bat in the first quarter. Didn't hear much from him since. Here we go inside again. Collins has a block from behind by Milhorn, and it's either a travel or a foul on the base.
Well, he was sandwiched by two players.
Yeah, the foul called against number five, Treviti. Sixth team foul. Williams gets it out to Myers. Myers and Richardson still there. Aquila. Richardson.
That came from the right hash mark about 26 feet out.
7 3-pointers. 1-1 now. As going to the line will be John Aquila, the junior.
That be his foul. Go ahead, Ron.
His first trip to the free throw line is team foul number 9.
And Myers is third. That was his third foul.
Yeah, that looks like a player that hasn't been in a lot. And there goes Richardson. And coming in will be Arnold in his stead. Yeah. Richardson, what a performance tonight from behind the arc. Taylor makes a second, so he's 2 for 2. That puts him in double figures for the night, but 24 points behind. It will be a tough row to hoe for the Panthers, the way Ranchview has been playing. And it's a game where Coach Boyd has been able to use practically everyone off the bench, and even some bigger guys underneath that hasn't had a lot of play. Baseline shot. That'll be a turnover against Collins at the 406 mark, and back in will be Chabot, and setting down will be Cram. It was 14-11 Ranchview after the first quarter. They opened up a 30-17 lead at the half, and then 44-27 after three. Milhorn having to chase that one down. Now he's double, triple teamed in the corner. And a foul called against 45, Caleb Arnold.
Well, they came to him like bees to honey, three of them just painting him in the corner.
If you just stand still, that's all you have to do. Milhorn misses the first free throw. He'll get another shot. Made his first two, has missed his last two. And missed that one as well. We go back to 6A next week, as we've had our Ranchview dose. We had the girls last week in a really fun game. Williams from behind the arc misses, and here comes Nowaka.
That was a good game over Lincoln last week.
Nowaka iron put back, though. Trevetti, his first 2 points of the game, no one really blocked him out underneath. And that'll happen. Arnold to Myers. It's Williams with the head fake. Williams, the lefty, and he hits.
All right, suited up, now got some points.
I'm trying to see if everyone, there's a couple of players yet to score for Ranchview. Missed. Ball loose, kick back around. Milhorn for three. Goes right over our photographer's head on the stage, and luckily there were not any assertive players trying to hit him high and hit him low. Myers almost lost control of it as we close in on 2 minutes of the fourth period. Inside stolen. Chabot waits. Go to Milhorn and back to Aquila. No one wants to really shoot it. Milhorn finally does and misses, and then he pushes Myers down, kind of in disgust. Stop the clock, just a second shy of 2 minutes. Well, we knew the pace couldn't last forever.
11 three-pointers tonight for the Wolves.
And it's just, that was the difference, really.
Yeah. Yep.
It was a three-point play. The Wolves have won all four times these schools have met. The closest, though, was last year. And that's good for Myers. He's now made his last two free throws.
When I see Collins, the 6'4 sophomore, there's the tape job on Cananan, Cole Cananan, who finished with 8 points, twisted his ankle. At least we think it's a bad ankle sprain. Trying to get some support.
Hey! That's good, good by Arnold on the breakaway. It was tipped around by Nawaka. Could have been goaltending. Ball went in anyway. Aquila wants a three-pointer, but we're going to have a foul on Myers against Trevetti. Myers ran right into him as he tried to place the screen. 2016, it was a 68-54 win for Ranchview and 62-51, so pretty close games. The year before, not so much. More or less kind of like what we're seeing tonight, where Ranchview won by 33 points. There's the scores in 2015 and 2016. Second shot is good. Trevitti with 3 points now. With about a buck and a half to go. Tell you what, Collins is a handful underneath.
Yeah,
with
and
his,
you know,
big friend.
Facially, he looks like Oliver Miller when Oliver Miller was a senior at Southwest High School.
Oliver got really big.
Yeah.
Myers pivots about three times. The lefty Thompson misses. Ball loose, and there's a man underneath playing hardball.
Collins is as tall as he is wide. Boy, that's a big, big body to
take care of underneath, isn't
wrestle it? With, yeah.
Under 60 seconds to go. John Nelson will try to track down D. Boyd when it's over. Get the post game underway. D, he just loves us. I say that in jest. A man of few words, Mr. Boyd, but he's fun to talk to when the microphone's not there. Going to the line, number three, Aquilo. He has made three in a row. Second shot is perfect, so he's four out of four, all coming here in the fourth quarter. 13 points for Aquilo, the junior. I was going to say, Ranchview, are you just going to sit on it? They're not a sit-on-it team. Collins will go to the hoop. Trevetti charged with the foul, but Kevin will now go to the line to shoot two with 39 seconds left on the clock. Talked about Ranchview and making postseason. I still think the biggest stat of all that is Coach Boyd was telling me he only lost in bi-district once. He went at least two rounds every time in postseason.
Well, that's almost a clean slate.
Yeah, that's good. Collins drags that one down. Nice hustle by the big man, Myers. He goes to the hoop, and he will go to the line to shoot two with 32 and a half seconds left to go.
19 points in this fourth quarter for the Wolves, about to go to 1-5 in district play. There's a 20th point this quarter.
Man, take makes another. So Myers, who did not do anything until pretty much the second half, making the most of his moments. Gunyal misses. Fast break. Thank goodness Myers caught that. Finished off by Arnold. He's in double figures with 10 points as we're closing in on the ball game. Little shot from the outside, missed, tapped around, picked up. Right to Gunyal, that will not count. 67-39 is the score. 67-39. When we come back, we'll talk to Coach Boyd, highlights and scores, so stay with us. So a 28-point win for the Ranchview Wolves, and down on the court side is John Nelson with the head coach of Ranchview. John?
All right, Earl, Ranchview winning 67-39, picking up district win number one, head coach D. Boyd. Coach, you got down a little bit in the first quarter, but you had a breakout second quarter, and you said when Jordan Richardson can hit the three, it could be a long night for the opposition.
Well, I hope I didn't say it like that, but if he's shooting, we have a good chance of winning, that's for sure.
What did you see out of this team? Because somebody was going to snap a losing streak tonight. Talk about that and what this says for the future, what you're trying to build for next year.
Well, we're a combination. I know this is going to sound a little weird, but we're a combination of a lot of older guys, and I have a lot of young boys. My older guys that are playing haven't had a lot of varsity experience, so because of that, they've seen some stuff that they haven't really seen before. My youngster, though, look bright. I'm hoping that we're going to improve. But you just never know. You just never know.
Coach, it's kind of nice when you can play just about everybody that's suited up.
That is nice. And trust me, we haven't had that opportunity a lot this year. Matter of fact, if we did have the opportunity, it's because we was down 30. But, yeah, it was nice to see the guys play. But you also got to take in consideration North Hill. These guys see each other. And a couple of my guys actually went to school here. So my guys might have been a little bit extra fired up for them. And we knew North Hill was going to be fired up because they played our opponents a whole lot better than we have. So we was expecting a close game, if not a L, to tell you the truth. They've been playing really good basketball. Coach do a good job over here with these guys.
All right, D, good luck the rest of the
Thank
way.
You. Trust me, we'll need it.
Head coach D. Boyd as Ranchview wins at 67-39. Back to you, Rob.
All right, John, thank you very much. D. Boyd, always fun to talk to, and he finally gets a smile after a ball game tonight as they win in style. But it wasn't easy in the first part of it, and thanks in part to John Aquillo. This guy had a really good game for the Panthers. That was a nice little feed there. And then he takes it to the hoop, a little fadeaway jump shot to hit a couple of his points, and he also made a three-pointer down the line. He scored in double figures. He had 13 tonight for the losers. But boy, here is the difference maker right here. And that's Jordan Richardson, the 5'9 senior, who averages about 36% from the three-point line. He hit them from everywhere. He hit them from the equestrian center. He hit them from the other side of 635. Anywhere he could, he made them count tonight, and that was the difference. Look at there, 23 points for the big guy there. Caleb Arnold had 9, and practically everyone on the bench tonight that got to play scored some points. Keela had 13, Milhorn had 10, Shabout 6, and there's the rest of the scoring for the Panthers tonight. But in the end, it was just Ranchview, just a little bit more experienced, and the hot shooting from the outside perimeter, the big difference with the capital B in tonight's victory over the Panthers. Again, 67-39, your final. For the entire ICTN crew and John Nelson, I'm Rob Willman. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on the ICTN Game of the Week.